Hi, I'm Sally Gates with iVideosongs, and today we're going to look at the CAGED system. So CAGED is an incredibly useful tool for unlocking the entire fretboard. It uses a system of chord shapes that connect in a recurring series up and down the neck. Learning this order will allow you to travel around the fretboard easily, staying in key no matter where you are. It's also going to help you to easily change keys. It'll take you beyond just playing your open chords, and you'll also be able to connect scales and improvise. And by the way, at the end of the play-along section of this lesson, there's a special treat. If you really want to work with CAGED and mix in a bit of soloing and scales, then stay tuned. Okay, so first off, let's look at what CAGED stands for. Each letter represents an open major chord, which are C, A, G, E, and D. So we're going to take all of these chord shapes that you're probably already familiar with and turn them into movable bar chords. So if you're not sure how to do this, you can check out our lesson on that here first. Okay, so let's take a look at how these work. So the way these chords connect is through the root notes. So if we wanted to take C major up and down the neck, for example, we know that we have our open C major right here. So this gives us the notes C, E, G, C, and E. So you'll notice that the root notes are here and here. And so now what we need to do is take the next chord shape in this CAGED series, which is A, and use that to connect up and make another C major chord. So if you look at your A shape, turning this into a bar chord, we start on that last root, and we get the same notes again. So C, G, C, E, and G. So you notice how it sounds slightly different to the open position. This is called a chord voicing, and it just means that it's how you're arranging the notes in the chord and whereabouts on the neck that you're playing it. So different voicings will give you different types of tones, but you're playing the same notes. Okay, so moving on, let's find the next chord shape in the series so we can keep playing C major up the neck. So looking at our A shape chord, we can see that we have the root notes here and here. So this top one is going to connect up with the next shape, which is the G shape bar chord. So we would make a bar covering that root note and then form the G shape chord with our C on the 8th fret. Okay, so now we have the same notes again. C, E, G, C, E, and C. So now we're going to form the next chord in the series, which is going to be the E major shape bar chord. So this is going to start from the root on the 8th fret, so our C there. So we form this E shape chord, and again we have the same pattern of notes. We have C, G, C, E, G, and C. Continuing up, we have D major. And so again, looking at the root notes, we have the C here, and then another C here. So we're going to form the D major shape around those. And now from here, the pattern starts again. We would go back to the C shape. So now we would look at where the highest root note is, and we form the C major shape around that. So now again, we have C, E, G, C, and E. Okay, so now let's say we wanted to change key and play an E major. We would do the exact same thing using this recurring cycle of shapes, but we would just start at a different point. So if we were in E, we would start in the open E shape, make the D shape, C shape, A shape, and so on. Okay, great. So now you can see how we can take one chord and travel up and down the neck using these root notes and chord shapes. So once you start to memorize this, you're going to see where your octave patterns are, and it's really going to unlock the fretboard as you can find any note wherever you are. So once you become familiar with how these chords join together, you can use this as a base for connecting scales together too. So this will allow you to travel freely around the fretboard rather than being confined to a single scale box. Okay, so let's take a look at how this would work if we connected two scales together. So a very common pentatonic scale that you might already know is this E minor or G major pentatonic shape. And one thing that you might not know is that this is based around the G major bar chord. So that tells us that if we want to travel down the fretboard, we would need to use an A-shaped chord to produce the scale form. So the pentatonic shape that's based around this chord would look like this. So now we can connect both of these up because we know that we're playing in the same key of E minor. So now we've just traveled over 7 frets to solo instead of just this one box. So we're really expanding what we can do on the guitar here now. Overall, this can be a challenging concept to get your head around and memorize. So go slow with this, and most importantly, enjoy the journey. It's really going to pay off in the long run and take the mystery out of the fretboard. So good luck.